I'm about to launch from the shadows like a lion on the grind coming at you. I'm a menace for the vengeance, so relentless. Hope you ready, cause I'm here to battle. Keeping me awake till the late night. Thinking about a wrong, I'ma make right. When you see me, better take flight. Venom in my veins and I'm all out of play nice. And it's bye-bye gone to the bygones. Ain't no turning back when the fight's on. When you see the white in my eyes, better run, better hide. No surviving what I'm on.
I ain't here to play around. If I were you, I would run right now. Make your feet bang, bang on the ground. Cause I'ma hunt you down, down, down. I'ma hunt you down. I'ma hunt you down, down, down. Yeah. Cause I'ma hunt you down. I'ma hunt you down.
What is up, guys? Dashing here for episode 16 of Octane. And we are jumping straight into the action, as always, the final episode of Octane, my friends, before Ascendance 10. It is less than a week away this upcoming Friday and Saturday, August the 5th and August the 6th. Do not miss it, but we have got a hell of a show leading us into the show of shows. And things getting started with the Ted going one-on-one with Andrew Briggs. Just want to check and make sure I'm coming through nice and clear, because I was having a lot of trouble with this headset of mine last night. So check, check, 1, 2. Bateman, can you hear my beautiful voice? Am I coming through clear enough for you? And at Ascendance 10, we know that the Ted will face his biggest challenge to date as he puts his career on the line against Machine Gun Kelly, who maybe a week ago we would have said Ted's gonna have no problem with MGK, but after what happened on the last episode of Octane, following the Ted's match against Matthew Justice, MGK ran down to the ring and beat the hell out of Ted. Left him knocked out in the ring. And if that happens at Ascendance 10, we're going to be saying, na 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 na, hey hey, goodbye to the Ted. Andrew Briggs, of course, set to lead Team Octane into battle on the grandest stage of them all. That's the sibling rivalry between our general managers here in CMV. Jackson Wright, Madison Wright reaches its apex. Bragging Wrights on the line. Team Shockwave versus Team Octane. And we see our general manager of Octane, Madison Wright, at ringside, keeping a close eye on her investment. The benchmark, Andrew Briggs. Of course, later on tonight, guys, Logan Paul makes his CMV debut. Wants a warm-up before that Shockwave Octane matchup at Ascendance 10. Tonight we've also got a last woman standing match as Kate Strongheart and Kyo look to finally settle their personal beef before heading into the Fatal 4-Way matchup at Ascendance 10 for the Women's World Championship. We've also got a street fight on hand as former tag team partners Violet Evans and Jane Stone to tear each other apart limb by limb. Will either even make it to the Magnificent Eight ladder match? A huge Fatal 4-Way Tornado Tag Team matchup in the main event. I see global champion Cam Harris, Richie James Harden take on the team of Jay Young and Jason Spade. The team of Bloody Justice and Blake Virtue. And last but not least, Ethan Parker and Troy Colt, as Ted is all over Andrew Briggs early on. Gotta say, Ted looked pretty damn good last episode of Octane, knocking off Matthew Justice, actually, with that pile driver right there. Not gonna go for the pin on Andrew Briggs. I'm sure Ted has eyes in the back of his head here tonight, not gonna let MGK punk him out once again with Ascendance 10 so close. But soak it in if you're a big Ted fan. This very well could be the last time we see him compete on Octane. If he loses to Machine Gun Kelly on Ascendance 10, it's all over for the 10. His downward spiral will fizzle. And the 10 will be no more. Briggs wanting to keep the momentum alive for Team Octane. Saw Joseph Santos and Fidel De La Rosa pick up a tag team victory last episode of Octane. And again, Logan Paul in action later on. What a kick to the head! To the corner, Andrew Briggs could be looking for that running knee. Decides against it though instead. Oh, knee to the jaw into an inverted Frankensteiner. Not much better for Teddy Boy as he follows it up with a deadlift power bar. Knee to the knee. Trying to eliminate the base of Big Ted, and now gonna look to hit that knee to the side of the head, but Ted giving too much time. Wow! What a spinning back elbow by Ted. And the Ted Buster to follow it up. One, two, nearly gets the win, but Andrew Briggs stays in the fight, perhaps not for much longer though. Ted with a forearm, just about decapitating Andrew Briggs. Madison Wright watching very closely from ringside for team captain Andrew Briggs. Octane debut, of course, after being betrayed by Jackson Wright. Madison bought his contract. He is now an Octane superstar. Has been given the lead at Ascendance 10. Drops down, does Ted, cheeky jab. Into the corner we go. Up on the top rope, could we be looking at a super TED? I think perhaps Ted sending a message to Machine Gun Kelly. This is what's coming for you at Ascendance 10. Super TED. Rushes into the cover, hooks the leg. One, two, rope break. The veteran Andrew Briggs with a second to spare. What ring awareness grabbing the bottom rope. Otherwise, that might have been a three count. Yeah. Forearm smash by Andrew Briggs goes for a stomp, but Ted able to get to his feet. Northern Light suplex floats over. What power from the Ted. Ted going to try for a camel clutch perhaps, but Andrew Briggs not going to let him lock it in. Looking for a pile driver of his own. Oh, no. That was a belly-to-back slam. That's not something you see very often. Shades of DDP there. Stiff kick to the middle of the back. Kick to the chest, though, caught by Ted. Turned into a dragon screw. Coming up next, guys, it is a rematch from last episode of Octane, as the Women's Hardcore Championship will be on the line. But wait a minute, Ted, looking for a TED. No. Shining Wizard! He just stole Andrew's finishing maneuver! One, two, three! Insult to injury as Ted beats Andrew Briggs with his own finisher. An exclamation point on a great match. And I said it last episode of Octane. This new aggression from Ted, I think, is what he's been missing. Two wins in a row. Ted is looking good. Machine Gun Kelly, eat your heart out. Ted, not to be outdone, A very clear message sent to Machine Gun Kelly. And anything can happen here in CMB, and especially on the grandest stage of all. Will this be the last time we see Ted on an episode of Octane? Drink it in, man. Drink it in. And coming up next, my friends, a rematch from the last episode of Octane, where Neon, of course, with a huge upset, knocking off Akiko to become the new Women's Hardcore Champion. But now has to put the title on the line as Akiko enacts her rematch clause. Neon knowing that come Ascendance 10, she's set to face Gianna Di Natale. Of course, Natale has not been seen, has not been heard from since Neon's vicious attack on her a few weeks ago. So it's honestly a legitimate question as to whether or not we're going to see that match. Will Natale be in good enough shape? Will the doctors clear her to compete at the show of shows? Neon can't worry about that right now. Going to prove that last episode of Octane was no fluke. What an impressive champion Akiko was. Only held the title for a few weeks, but was a fighting champion after capturing the title inside of the Elimination Chamber at Purgatory, defended it against Natale in a 2 out of 3 falls tables match, and then in a triple threat match against All of Us and Riot. But perhaps underestimated Neon. Come on, let's go. In their matchup, in the last episode of Octane, Akiko not going to make that mistake here tonight. Go. Get up. Of course, this is Extreme Rules. Anything goes with the Women's Hardcore Championship on the line. Will Akiko allow herself to be caught off guard again? sure the Painter of Pain would love nothing more than to walk into that match at Ascendance 10 with the Women's Hardcore Championship over her shoulder. Here we go, Neon Hakiko, Women's Hardcore Championship on the line. Second matchup of the evening, guys, still so much to look forward to. The women are really getting down and dirty here tonight. Of course, we got that last woman standing match a little bit later on between Kate Strawhart and Kyo. And then a street fight. Violet Evans takes on Jane Stone. Well, now open palm strikes. Dion has certainly proven herself to be a lethal striker in the women's division. Big kick to the side of the head, and another one, a third. Now going after the knee, there's a final kick, takes out Neon. Good God. Target the knees. Neon has a very impressive record thus far in her CMB career. Only been defeated a couple of times. German suplex to a Dragon suplex, and finally the straight jacket German suplex. Taking Neon around town right now. There's a stiff to the side of the head, which Neon takes on the chin. An absolute pimp and into a modified cross face now. Neon looking to get a submission out of Hakiko here to retain the Women's Hardcore Championship. But Hakiko gonna break. Oh, look who it is! Look who it is! It's Gianna Di Natale! And remember, there are no disqualifications! As the Women's Hardcore Championship is on the line! Neon's running! Neon's running! She wants nothing to do with Gianna Di Natale! But now she's got a sledgehammer! Natale with the knee! Natale with the knee! Hakiko capitalizes! One! Two! Oh, but kicks out! And I guess Gianna Di Natale is A-OK, ready to go. I wasn't sure if she would make it to Ascendance 10, but after that, she's looking pretty damn good to me. And Hakiko with no qualms taking advantage, but Neon still with some fight left in her. Irish whip out onto the apron. Gianna Di Natale, as quickly as she appeared, she has vanished again. Almost as if Neon saw a ghost. High kick after the knife edge chop. Kick to the midsection though. No count outs as Neon tries to throw out a knee. Double leg takedown into the full mount. Blasting Hakiko with those open palm strikes. Neon trying to shake it off. Back into the ring, trying to bring out a baseball bat. Hakiko not gonna give it the chance to use it though. Shinbreaker into the back suplex. These fans chanting, "We want tables." I guess the 2 out of 3 falls tables match a couple weeks ago just wasn't enough for them. Hakiko back into the ring. She wants the sledgehammer, evidently. Oh, Neon's in for it now. Still feeling the effects of that knee from Natale. There's a sledgehammer shot to the gut. More kicks, just can't keep up with Hakiko. But this is not false count anywhere, guys. Hakiko's got to get her back into the ring, pin her or submit her to win the Women's Hardcore Championship. Another knee. Northern Lights suplex. Natale watching from the back now. Smile on her face, I'm sure. Feel real good to cost Neon the Women's Hardcore Championship here tonight. Look on Neon's face was priceless, man. She couldn't believe it. She better believe it. She better believe right now that Hakiko means business. These two are just beating the hell out of each other. Out of the side headlock, punch between the eyes. Rapid. Punch to the face, man. Neon, one tough cookie to crack. Most would have been done for after that knee from Natale and then the German suplex from Hakiko, but Neon is still fighting. And there's the table. The fans gonna get what they want. Oh, but decides to throw it away. Eon teasing the CMB Universe. The cheek on her. Akiko, though. Able to take her down with that reverse DDT. Eon saying, you want tables? Well, too bad. Eon gets back into the ring. Akiko to her feet already. She is going for the table. Trying to get the fans what they want, but Eon gonna throw her back into the ring. Eon might have eyes to try and finish Akiko off here, but Akiko's quicker. Elbow to the jaw. Eon looking for that downward spiral perhaps, but Akiko with these kicks, man, they are non-stop. That decapitating kick sends some teeth flying, I'm sure. One, two. No. Akiko has Eon hurting. Looks to hammer the final nail into the coffin, go for the Fisherman's Driver, but Eon reverses. Eon gets herself a chance. Back under the ring. What now? A kendo stick right to the head of Akiko, and again. Now we're gonna try to go to town on her. Akiko fighting through the pain. Cross arm bar locked in, but remember, it's not Falls Count Anywhere. So even if Eon were to tap, which she doesn't, it wouldn't matter. It's gotta happen in the ring. Speaking of the ring, people gonna use it as a weapon there, throwing Eon chest first into the apron. Oh, and now Akiko looking for a bit of payback. Smacking Eon between the eyes and a shot to the ribs as well. Eon with a shot to the ribs. And right down across the back, Akiko rolls out of the way, kicking the kendo stick out of Neon's hands. How about those reflexes? Akiko takes her time getting back into the ring. Eon looking like she's in another dimension right now. Akiko looking for Hakiko's Law. Eon reverses it though. What a combination. My lord, Eon just not satisfied in this match, man. You had a sledgehammer, a baseball bat, a table, a kendo stick, and now a steel chair, but Akiko cuts her off as she's getting back into the ring. Hammerlock, vertical suplex. Goes for the pin out of desperation. One, two. Women's Hardcore Championship is on the line. Akiko has got the upper hand right now, but can she keep it that way? Eon is not going down without a fight here tonight. More kicks. Kick up under the knee by Eon. Going for that snapmare, trying to set up that sliding kick of hers, which won her the Women's Hardcore Championship last episode of Octane. He's in the corner now, stomping a mud hole in Akiko. Good lord. Taking that arm, extending it. Looking to stomp to the exposed hand. And Neon's got the steel chair. Gonna wedge it between the top rope and the middle rope. This is not looking good for Akiko. The snapmare sets up the sliding kick to the side of the head. I guess it was just an insurance policy. One, two, no! What? Eon can't believe it, and neither can I, but not again! Not again! One, two, three. Eon is still the Women's Hardcore Champion. What toughness shown by Eon here tonight, even after the run-in by Gianna Di Natale. Eon persevered. And Not once but twice, Neon kicking Hikiko in the head to keep her down. And Neon, still the women's hardcore champion, and it's pretty clear that the match is on now at Ascendance 10. Natale is ready to go. Question is, will Neon be ready for the wrath of Natale that she has incurred? Coming up next to keep things rolling here on Octane Episode 16, we have got some mixed tag team action that we'll see in Amare Rivers and Isabella Almas take on the team of Ashley Riott and the new international champion, Amber Reed. Of course, capturing that championship last episode of Octane in a hellacious triple threat matchup against Jay Young and the former champion, Kwame Bullitt. Amare Rivers very recently went on live and talked a whole lot of trash about Amber Reed specifically. Evidently has a very big problem with Amber Reed competing in both divisions, fighting men and women, taking up time that could be given to himself or the love of his life, Isabella Almas. And Amare promising to throw Amber Reed off the top of a ladder at Ascendance 10. Of course, both of them a part of the Money in the Bank ladder match. And R.A. Rivers has been on quite a roll as of late. A couple of weeks ago, defeating Josh Wolf in last episode of Octane, knocking off Troy Colt. He continued to build on that momentum here tonight. R.A. Rivers also very agitated at the fact that Isabella Almas is not on the Ascendance card. Says it's a downright travesty. And there she is. Man, is it good again to see Amber Reed with a championship in her hand. It's been a long road back to the top for Amber Reed. Many mishaps along the way, but the history maker has returned to form. Last episode of Octane, capturing that international championship in an incredible triple threat matchup. Now, once again, Amber Reed feels as though she's at her best. Letting it be known that it doesn't stop here. Now she's got her eyes on the Money in the Bank briefcase. It doesn't care if it's Amare Rivers or any of the six other competitors in the match. She will secure that briefcase. She will cash it in to again become world champion. Reed's tag team partner here tonight, Ashley Riott, part of the Magnificent Eight ladder match. She just recently got done putting down Alexia Diamond in this past episode of Aftershock in a no holds barred matchup, after Alexia Diamond was talking a whole lot of trash about Ashley Riott being put in Magnificent Eight over her. Riott has been on a bit of a roll as of late. Looking to finally break through that glass ceiling, if you will. Since debuting last season, Riott has had many opportunities at the Women's Tag Team Championship, the Women's World Championship, and the Women's Hardcore Championship, but has always come up short. Will it be the same story at Ascendance 10? Or are we looking at Miss Magnificent 8 right there? Things can get started between Amare Rivers and Amber Reed, and evidently, the way I see it, Amare Rivers will fight Amber Reed, and Isabella Almas will fight Ashley Riott. Riott, of course, not a experienced competitor in the men's division like Amber Reed, but Amare Rivers getting things started, just tossing Amber Reed all around the ring like a rag doll, and now dragging her over to the corner. Stopped, though, by the international champion. Shots to the midsection. Oh, man, and a knee to the face. Pete saying, talking a whole lot of shit. Amare, but not backing it up here tonight. Oh, now it's a bicep. Come, guys, we've got Logan Paul making his CMV debut as he hopes to get his feet wet before Team Shockwave versus Team Octane match at Ascendance 10. We've also got the last woman standing match. Kate Stronghart and Tia will face off. Let's not forget the street fight between Violet Evans and Jane Stone. Will either of them even make it to the Magnificent Eight ladder match is a genuine question, depending on what they do to each other later on. Look at Ashley Riott choking out Isabella Almas, but it's not giving satisfaction there. O'Connor roll. Pele kick. Taking Riott down, but gets a kick of her own right upside the head. By the Deathmatch Princess. Walking Isabella over to the corner. Perhaps looking to make a tag, maybe not. Forearm smash, gonna take Almas down, trying her best to break through the defenses of Isabella. There we go, nasty stomp. And smashing almost face first off the mat, tag to Amber Reed. So back in comes Amare Rivers. High kick, goes for a forearm smash, blocked though by Amare. Quick springboard cross body. Wily is Amare Rivers. Crafty. Very unorthodox. Lean up against the ropes, the international champion. Looking up something right now that Amare is not gonna like. Decapitating him on the top rope. And a tag to Ashley Riott. Out of the way of Almas there, hook to the jaw from behind, back suplex, countered by Almas mid-air into a cross body. And there's the power of Isabella Almas. Both she and Amare Rivers, incredibly powerful but also very agile. As we see right there with that standing moonsault, now up to the top rope, Isabella Almas, the Swanton Bomb. Senton Riott is not having a very good time right now. Super kick not going to continue. Able to counter. Actually, Riott giving herself some breathing room, grabbing Isabella by the hair, slamming her down onto the mat. Actually, Riott talking a little bit of trash. Get a elbow there. The corner almost a sent. Ashley Riott could be setting her up. The sliced bread! What's the leg? Will that be enough? One! Oh! Amare Rivers distracting referee Johnson there. Forcing Ashley Riott to break the pin. It takes a bite out of Isabella's forehead, trying to set her up for the Riott Act. But almost rapid barrage of kicks. Now going downstairs. Headbutt to the pelvis and a tag to Amare Rivers. Knee to the jaw, gonna bring him off his feet. Push back. Big man up, trying to pounce before Reed has a chance to get to her own feet. Enziguri knocks her down to the outside. Just gonna watch her from the ring. Oh shit! Springboard elbow, but completely whiffed it. First of the steel steps. Tries for a stomp. Amare rolls out of the way, goes for a kick, but Amber Reed caught it. Reflexes, man, just too much. Now Amare. I'm sure at this point regretting all that shit he was talking on live about Amber Reed a few days ago. Reed, not too sure what she wants to do here. Sizing Amare up, waiting very patiently for him to snap out of it. Gets back into the ring, breaks the count. Amber Reed wants to do some more damage to Amare here at ringside. Amare, oh my god. Going for a powerbomb, countered into a roll-up, but this is not false pin anywhere. Another knee to the midsection. Amare says enough of that. Throws her back into the ring. Amare, though, not quick enough. Amber Reed with that backbreaker, neckbreaker combination. Dragging Amare into the corner. This is not where he wants to be right now. Oh, a high kick. Puts him down right into a full mount. Amber Reed. With some serious piss and vinegar in that ring tonight. For good reason. Amare loves to run his mouth. Some might say it's what he's best at. Goes for a pin, but only a one count. The international champion. Not finished though. Gonna go for that Shira Inui or a cutter? Oh, but a power slam. Great. reversal by Rivers and immediately makes the tag to Almas. Two staring each other down, Irish whip. Sent Almas down to the outside. And Ashley Riott takes the second. Makes the tag to Amber Reed, why not? I'm already like, goddamn, man, come on. I just got out onto the apron. Trying to take a breather, but there are no breaks in that CMB ring. Too short, Ashley Riott. Gentleman's clutch, though, from Maray. Doesn't seem to do very much to Amber Reed. Gets right back up. Face first off the top turnbuckle. Setting her up for that delayed moonsault. Vintage of Maray, but delayed perhaps a little bit too long. And Amber Reed able to get the knees up. Maray still wants to fight, but the tag was made to Ashley Riott. Rapid kicks to the face. Head sends her down to the outside. Ashley Riott continuing to clear the ring. Gets a bit impatient though. Almost is trying to get back to her feet. Big boot from Riott. Into a knee bar. Amare really wants to help out his girl, but if he lays hands on Ashley Riott, it'll be a disqualification. Face to keep her down. Riott with nowhere to go right now. Cornered by Isabella Almas, just having her way with the Deathmatch Princess. Oh my God, back suplex onto the barricade. I think I heard the crunch of Riott's spine from over here. Riott has had much worse done to her throughout her wrestling career. You can just look at her body and tell that much, the scars. On her abdomen, on her chest, on her face. Both women now mocking each other. Isabella takes her time getting back into the ring. Riott waiting for her, but Isabella's the quicker. Irish whip into the corner. Elbow to the side of the head, stuns Almas. Gives Riott a chance, but walks right into a super kick. And then a monkey flip. Up to the top rope. Perfect positioning here. The Phoenix Splash connects. One, two. Only a two count. Ashley Riott, much to the chagrin of Isabella Almas, able to kick out there. And we saw Amare Rivers destroy Amber Reed in the corner. Eat defeat coming out of nowhere. One, but a rope break for Almas. Well done. Almas trying to get back in the fight here. Almost had the match won just a minute ago. Double knee face breaker. Woo! Big chop. Down out of the chest. Smash. Dragon screw. Things not looking good for Isabella right now as Ashley Riott is all over her like peanut butter and jelly. Takes another bite out of her forehead and a chop block. Nice little combo there. Very cheap. Extends the arm. Stomp. Elbow and a tag to Amber, and he saw Amari Rivers almost hesitant to get in the ring. Big time. And Amber Reed, how about one more? The Revolution knee connects, hooks the leg. One, two, three, no. 2.999. Amber Reed gonna let Ashley Riott try to finish this match. That's right to a hook to the jaw though, and we've seen this time and time again from both Isabella and Amare, the torture rack stretch. Dropping her chest and face first. One, two, no. Bella not done though. Back up to the top rope, looking for that Phoenix Splash. Riott not going to give her the chance. Isabella perched on the top rope, decides against it. Riott's going to utilize this opening, tossing her into the corner. Going to set up the Riott Act! Johnson, don't want to get caught between these two right now. High kick, knee to the gut, tries for a punch, caught though. Going for a ride. Drop chest first on that top rope. And Amare takes a look around as he sets up that standing 450 splash. Does he have the match won? Uno, dos, broken up by Riott. Amare just doing his best to ignore Ashley Riott, going back on the attack. Up to the second rope, could be looking for that European uppercut of his. Yes, he is, but Amber Reed able to step out of the way, tag to Ashley Riott. Isabella almost has to be feeling some type of way right now. I mean, her jaw's got to be hanging on by a thread after the Riott Act twice and the Eat Defeat twice. To a gentle clutch. Ella trying to keep her head above the water. Easier said than done, though. There's that beautiful O'Connor roll. Pele kick to the top rope. The Phoenix Splash incoming. Hits it a second time. Hooks the leg. One, two. No. Unbelievable. Ashley Riott kicking out of the Phoenix Splash. Not once, but twice. But it certainly did some damage. Gonna have to make the tag to Amber Reed. I'd have to put the team on her back here. Bumping into each other. All right. Ooh! Rainboard moonsault into a last chancery. Last chancery broken up by Ashley Riott. Takes the arm. Smashes it off the canvas. Now Amare gonna get funky as he looks to drop that leg, but Amber Reed's not having any of it. Snapmare, kick right to the side of the head. Just a big neon fan, hooks the leg, one, but grabs the rope, man. Say what you will about Amare and Isabella. They have great ring awareness. Oh, Reed, looking for the Revolution knee a second time, but Amare's having none of it. Tagged to Isabella Almas. Ashley Riott's going right after her with that elbow. Elbow. Counters back and forth out. Ashley Riott starting to let her up, but Almas fires back. Tit for tat here. There's the choke. This time taking Almas off her feet. Has to be careful not to get disqualified, though. This now from Ashley Riott, a deadlift German suplex. What strength exhibited by the deathmatch princess. Just Riott have to do to keep down Isabella Almas, man? She's hit the Riott Act twice. Oh, not again. The torture act stretch into the drop. Hooks the leg. Will that finally do it? One, two. No. Actually, Riott just giving up the fight of her life here tonight. A third Phoenix Splash. There's no way she kicks out of that. But Amber Reed taking a page out of Amare's playbook, distracting Johnson. And Johnson's really got to get his head on straight. Keeps letting himself get played like a fool. Oh, what's this? What is this? Amare trying to come in. Amber Reed stops him, though. And look at this. Tandem offense. Shining Wizard hooks the leg. One, two, three. What? There ain't no way. There ain't no way. How did Amare kick out? I thought it was over for sure, man. I would have bet my bottom dollar this match was over. Tornado DDT into a triangle choke. Triangle choke applied. Amber Reed gonna make Amare tap here tonight. Actually, Riott and Amber Reed victorious. What a match. One of the best mixed tag team matches I have seen. One of the best matches of this season, period, I'd say. And what a win for these two going into Ascendance 10. Hey, this time next week, we could see both of them with a briefcase. As Ashley Riott, of course, in Magnificent 8, and Amber Reed in the Money in the Bank ladder match. That would be a sight to see. That is right, my friends. Your eyes do not deceive you. It is time to see Logan Paul make his CMV debut, requesting this matchup so that he could get his feet wet. before Ascendance 10, where of course he will be a part of the massive Team Shockwave versus Team Octane match. And well, after Shockwave General Manager Jackson Wright disrespected him, Logan Paul agreeing to be a part of Team Octane. And tonight he takes on the debuting Nikki Nitro. What an opportunity for this kid to potentially embarrass the megastar Logan Paul. But not coming alone. Logan Paul gonna have some backup as Andrew Briggs, the team captain of Team Octane, has told both Fidel De La Rosa and Joseph Santos to keep an eye on the Playboy. And there he is, Logan Paul, making his CMB debut. Was originally just gonna be the special guest host of Ascendance 10, but thanks to Jackson Wright and that mouth of his, now Logan Paul is coming to personally pay Jackson Wright back in the ring at Ascendance 10. Imagine Jackson Wright is watching from home right now on the edge of his couch, hoping to God that Logan Paul gets embarrassed here and then maybe second guesses himself, decides to not be a part of Team Octane at Ascendance 10. But I don't see the Shockwave General Manager getting so lucky as Nikki Nitro with a hot start here, choking out Logan Paul on the top rope and a kick to the back of the knee. Anarchy champion Fidel De La Rosa. Joseph Santos watching from ringside. They picked up a great win last episode of Octane. Can Logan Paul keep the momentum at an all-time high? Going into Ascendance 10. Nikki Nitro, though, looking to make the most of this opportunity. Still to come here tonight, guys. We've got that last woman standing match as Kate Strawhart and Kyo finally prove between them who is the better woman going into the Fatal 4-Way matchup at Ascendance 10 for the Women's World Championship. We've got Ogre Vex in action, guys, looking to remain undefeated as he goes into the I Quit match against Adam Valentine at Ascendance 10. We've also got that street fight, Milo Demons and Jane Stone. Gonna go to war. Either of them make it to Ascendance 10 in the Magnificent 8 ladder match. It's a genuine question. Our main event gonna be that huge Fatal 4-Way Tornado Tag Team match. Four participants in the Global Championship Fatal 4-Way matchup at Ascendance 10, tasked with finding partners here tonight. Momentum, all important, so close to the show of shows. Nikki Nitro, guys, doing a great job here early on, bullying Logan Paul. Look at this now, mocking him from the ring. But Fidel De La Rosa and Joseph Santos giving Logan Paul some moral support, egging him on. He's looking for a fist bump, but it seems like De La Rosa and Santos not willing to go that far. Nikki Nitro getting a bit impatient here. Logan Paul taking his time getting back into the ring, cut off by Nitro. Great combination put together here by the Maverick with a knee to the jaw and a kick to the face and a stomp to the chest. Things looking good. Logan Paul right now. Oh, he's looking for the Three Amigos. There's one. There's two. Will we get the third? Yes, we will. And the kip up. Logan Paul on fire right now. He's loving it. Will that be enough? One. Now, Logan on their feet though, as he goes up to the top rope. Oh, looking for that frog splash. Knees, Nitro gets up the knees. Tries to capitalize, but not quick enough. Logan Paul right back on the attack. Stomp to the shoulder. Now holding his boot out onto the gut. Poor Nikki Nitro. not afraid to show off just a little bit. Logan Paul with the headstand out of the side headlock. Again, putting some serious pressure on the midsection of Nitro. Logan Paul having his way. Nikki Nitro here tonight on Octane episode 16. Things started off pretty rough. It might not get any better. Nikki Nitro, a stiff kick to the middle of the back into a standing shooting star press. Goes up to the top rope himself. What is Nikki Nitro looking for here? Oh, goes for a low down, but Logan Paul gets the knees up. And a running power slam. Great form if you ask me. Look at that perfect positioning. Gonna go for the frog splash a second time. The knees! Good lord! Knees here tonight. Oh, I busted my knee. Now going after the legs of Logan Paul, trying to stop him from going up to that top rope again. My lord, just elbow drop after elbow drop to the knee. To the top rope, he's gonna go for the lowdown again, I would guess. No! Holy shit! 630 senton! One, two! Oh, Paul kicks out of it. Oh no, another three amigos! And these fans are loving it. The CMB Universe joining Logang here tonight. Third, or really sixth, vertical suplex. One, two, three, Logan Paul, victorious in his CMB debut. A bit iffy at first, but in the end, he got it together. And Logan Paul, not to be trifled with. Jackson Wright, you dug your own grave. Logang is coming to Ascendance 10, repping Octane. And the action continues to get hotter and hotter here tonight on Octane episode 16 as Kate Strawhart and Keo look to settle the score one-on-one once and for all in this last woman standing match. That means no pinfalls, no submissions, no countouts, no disqualifications. The only way to win is to incapacitate your opponent so that they cannot reach the referee's count of 10, can't get back to their feet in time. And in the past, Kate Strongheart has time and time again gotten the better of Kyo. Kate Strongheart, one of the main reasons Kyo's reign as Women's World Champion didn't go so well. But of course, these two women, along with Ashley Rain and the champ herself, Ellie Quinn, going to be a part of that fatal four-way matchup at Ascendance 10 for the Women's World Championship. Going to be every woman for herself. One of them will leave the grandest stage of them all as the Women's World Champion. Earlier this week on Shockwave, we saw Ellie Quinn knock off Ashley Rain in an Extreme Rules match. Kyo's been building a whole lot of momentum in recent weeks, finally putting some wins together. She get perhaps her biggest win yet against No Nonsense, someone who has continuously had her number. And I don't think there's going to be any trackers involved, but I'm sure this is still going to be a hard-hitting affair, just like our street fight later on tonight between Violet Evans and Jane Stone. The women really up against it here tonight. Earlier we saw Neon and Hikiko just beat the hell out of each other for the Women's Hardcore Championship. So here we go, last woman standing. Again, no pinfalls, no submissions, no countouts, no disqualifications, anything goes. And the only way to win is to knock out your opponent. You gotta get back up before 10, otherwise it is game over. Midsection blocked by Kyo, not able to do much though against the rest of that combination as Kate Strongheart goes after the arm early on. Kyo with a sweep. Gonna stop trying to keep Kate Strongheart down. Gets the midsection caught. The back and forth here. First minute of the matchup, double wrist clutch, Northern Lights suplex. Into a fisherman's driver. Spinning European uppercut, denied by Kyo, the former Women's World Champion. Like I said, has been on a roll as of late. The best we've seen Kyo since she won the Women's World Championship, really. Stomp down onto the arm, and Ashley Rain, Ellie Quinn, I'm sure both watching this matchup, feeling the effects of their Extreme Rules match on Shockwave, but preparing for the fatal four-way at Ascendance 10 with the Women's World Championship on the line. Friendship's going to be thrown out the window. One woman can leave. Show of shows with that crown jewel around their waist. Strongheart targeting the knees. You know, if Kate Strongheart takes out Kyo's knees, locks in that sharpshooter, Kyo not going to be able to get back to her feet. Irish whip sends Strongheart into the corner. Cautious approach. Slamming Kate Strongheart face first. Off the top turnbuckle, we've seen Kyo becoming a lot more aggressive in recent weeks. That's what she was missing all along. Benefit her here tonight. Butterfly suplex out of the corner. Coming up next, guys, Ogre Vex is in action, looking to remain undefeated as he goes into Ascendance 10 to meet Adam Valentine in the I Quit match. Look at this! Knee bar applied by the Queen of Hearts. Obviously came to this match with a strategy to tear apart that knee, perhaps make sure Kyo doesn't make it to Ascendance 10. Odds for Kate Strongheart if it were to be turned into a triple threat match. Kyo's not about to let that happen though. Pendulum backbreaker. And a stomp down on the arm. Kick to the back. Pulling at Kate's arm. Seems like she's zeroed in on that left shoulder specifically. Against the ropes, not where Strongheart wants to be. Bounces back with an elbow. And woo! And Strongheart gonna let referee Johnson start the count. Strongheart stayed out. Oh, breaks the count herself. She may have had it won right there, but wants to do some more damage, I guess. And Kyo will take advantage of the snap vertical suplex. Now Kyo's going to let the count happen. Will that vertical suplex be enough to keep Kate Strongheart down? Kyo's hoping so. No! That stomp, obviously. Kyo does not think it will be enough. Oh, but the double knee facebreaker might. That might do it. Kyo feeling herself right now. No! Breaks the count at two. Both of these women just want to beat the hell out of each other. A lot of pent-up frustration being let loose in this match. Now Kyo gonna let the count go down as Kate Strongheart incapacitated at ringside. Up to a count of five already. Six. Seven. Eight, guys. Kate Strongheart, oh man, gets back to her feet at eight. I thought it was over right there. Kyo exits the ring and immediately gets caught with that inverted suplex. Strongheart keeping her distance, lining up Kyo, being a bit cautious. Throwing her into the barricade with that German suplex. Johnson tries to start a count, but Strongheart's like, no, I ain't done. Not another chop. Johnson starts his count as Strongheart gets back into the ring. Three. Four. Strongheart finally gonna actually try to win this match. Six. Back up to her feet. Kyo's got a lot of fight in her, we know that. Hell, we learned that her first couple of weeks here in CMB. The heart and soul of Kyo. Oh no, what is this? What is this? Kate Strongheart snapping the arm of Kyo over her knee. That was sick, and I heard a crunch, guys. I heard a crunch and a crack. Kyo may have just broke her arm. Staring up the lights, Kyo not moving that left arm of hers at all, guys. It might be broken. Eight. Nine, guys, that's it. 10. Kate Strongheart victorious. Guys, I think Kyo's got a broken arm. We need to get the doctors out here right now. Kyo could not move her left arm at all. I swear I heard a pop. Kate Strongheart with a vicious victory, and we need to get Kyo to the back right now. Guys, I don't know if Kyo's gonna make it to Ascendance 10 after what Strongheart just did to her. And look at Strongheart, proud of herself. Get the docs out here now.
mind, help me exercise my mind.
That is right, my friends. We are as close can be to Ascendance 10. It is less than a week away. This upcoming Friday and Saturday, August the 5th and August the 6th. Do not miss it. Mark your calendars. Set your alarms. It is going to be the biggest show in CMV history. If you're a member of our Discord, partake in the predictions contest. Couple of cheeky rewards you could earn if you are correct. And you're pretty chance. Don't forget, as announced earlier this week, we'll be doing a giveaway during Ascendance 10. All you got to do is show up to the stream, listen closely, do that Cody Rhodes gif where he's got his hand to his ear for the keyword, and then type it in chat. You'll be automatically entered. Could win a $15 gift card to Xbox or PSN, the victor's choice. You know what, Ogre Vex is looking to win in Ascendance 10? Looking to win the I Quit match and end the CMB career of Adam Valentine. After months of Ogre Vex continuously attempting to kill Adam Valentine, throwing him off the top of some scaffolding, hitting him with a steel chair over 10 times, nothing has kept the goat down. It was Adam Valentine who actually challenged Ogre Vex to the I Quit match at Ascendance 10. And Adam Valentine saying, if you can beat me, Ogre, if you can get me to say I quit, I will. I will quit CMB. I will leave forever. Ogre Vex very quickly accepting. He wants nothing more than to get rid of Adam Valentine permanently. To remain undefeated here tonight, though. Ogre Vex with one of the most impressive records here in CMB in the new season. Nobody has been able to touch this man. Man's not the right word, this beast. And I don't know if his opponent is going to fare very well. Hey, I'm not the kind of guy to judge a man based on his appearance, but something tells me Blaze Kush making his CMB debut, not going to stand much of a chance against Ogre Vex, but I don't count anyone out fully. And from what I've heard, this kid is incredible on the independent scene, calls himself the highest flyer. Getting himself acquainted with the CMB universe, he has no idea what he's in for here. Once that bell rings, though, he will. Where did you get that towel from? Wait a minute. Is he a magician too? Move over, Alvarez. Where the hell did he get that towel from? Where was he hiding that towel? There we go. Blaze Kush going to try his hand at ending the unbeaten streak of Ogre Vex. Of course, Adam Valentine, guys, watching from home. He's been given very special permission to compete. At Ascendance 10, he had to beg and plead with the CMB doctors to clear him. He knows this is going to be the biggest match of his CMB career. Everything on the line for the GOAT of CMB as Ogre Vex starts by dropping Blaze Kush face first on that top turnbuckle. Push back into the corner. Blaze Kush doing his best to even approach Ogre Vex. Does this man have a smiley face shaved into his chest hair? I'm sorry, am I seeing things? Please tell me if I'm seeing things. I swear he has a smiley face shaved into his chest hair. Well, who does this guy think he is, man? Ogre Vex. Dropped out of the military press. Going after the ankle, Vex having his way with the rookie here. Coming up next, guys, on Octane episode 16, it's the street fight between Violet Evans and Jane Stone, former tag team partners, try to kill each other here tonight. And the Magnificent Eight ladder match at Ascendance 10, and of course in our main event, that fatal four-way tornado tag team matchup, as the participants in the global championship match passed with finding themselves some partners here tonight. Go to battle for that all-important momentum, plays Kush, tweaking as he drops that knee. Gonna rally the CM Universe. I think he's already got a lot of fans in the crowd. Running Bulldog. They love Blaze Kush here on Octane. Stomp out of the hand. Stomp out of the middle of the back. Blaze Kush, look at this. With a pseudo camel clutch. Cupping the ears of Ogre Vex, but doesn't stay in it for very long. Ogre now back in the driver's seat, using the top rope, try and chop off the head of Blaze Kush, and there's that spine buster. The monster goes for the pin. One, two. Blaze Kush though, showing just a bit of resolve, might be for naught though, as Ogre Vex looks for vexation. Blaze Kush countered. Blaze Kush just countered vexation, but can't do much with the counter as Vex just instantly throws him down with that hatch suplex. And now a deadlift running power slam hooks the leg. One, two. Damn, all right. Hey, I said I wasn't fully counting out Blaze Kush. Any man with two hands has a fighting chance, as a wise man once said. Going after the eyes of Blaze Kush, those eyes that are very suspiciously red. I don't know why that could be. Takes the arm, smacks it off the canvas, and now Vex. A barrage of elbow drops across the chest. And smashing Blaze's arm off the mat. And right into some more elbow drops. Ogre Vex playing with his food here. That's what this is. Grabbing him by that hair. Irish whip throws him out onto the apron. Ogre Vex with a hook to the jaw. And again, but Blaze Kush able to catch it the second time. Springboard. Holy shit. West Coast up to the top rope. Blaze Kush, the highest flyer. With a Phoenix. Out of the way just in time, and vexation connects. Thanks for coming, Blaze Kush. One, two, three. Ogre Vex remains undefeated. A valiant attempt by Mr. Blaze Kush, but in the end, Ogre Vex claims another victim. Remains unbeaten, and that's what Adam Valentine has to deal with come Ascendance 10 and the I Quit match. Best of luck to you, Valentine. You're going to need it. Valentine has proven time and time again he is not so easily put down for the count. But against a monster like Ogre Vex, what chance does any man stand? And into our co-main event we go, lads and gents, here on Octane, episode 16. And this is a street fight between former tag team partners Violet Evans and Jane Stone. Neither of them might make it to Ascendance 10 in the Magnificent 8 ladder match, depending on what they do to each other here tonight. These two, certainly an odd pairing at the top of the new season, but found great success, as they say, opposites attract, and became women's tag team champions. However, short while after winning the gold, losing them, Violet Evans instantaneously started throwing out these jabs here and there, insinuating that Jane Stone had cost them the titles, that Jane Stone was the weak link, this and that, week after week, just comment after comment. Finally getting under Jane Stone's skin, the two decided to have a friendly matchup to prove who the weak link is, and Violet Evans won that match. Jane Stone saying, all right, you proved it. I'm the weak link now. Let's get back on track. Let's put our heads together. Let's capture the titles. And, well, they had a shot, but came up short. And that's when Violet Evans finally had enough, deciding to dissolve the team, but apparently that wasn't good enough. She brutally attacked Jane Stone, beat the hell out of her a few weeks ago. Now Jane Stone is coming to get some revenge. Jane Stone no longer willing to just sit off to the side and take it on the chin. She's coming to make Violet Evans pay for all that shit she's been talking, for all the attacks. Say what you will about Violet Evans, she has been very impressive over this past month, currently undefeated as a singles competitor. Will that come to an end at the hands of her former tag team partner? Guys, this is a street fight. That means no countouts, no disqualifications. You can only win by pinfall or submission, but it is false count anywhere. Right into a snap vertical suplex. You can see these two even came dressed for a fight. This ain't gonna be a match. I'm sure the rest of the Magnificent 8 competitors are loving that these two are competing in this matchup here tonight. Neither one of them are going to walk into the Magnificent 8 ladder match at 100%. They'll be lucky to walk the match at all. They might have to crawl down the ramp at Ascendance 10. Good time. Knee drop. Oh, Bateman is the biggest Sophia Caldwell fan. Thrown into the steel steps again. This is false count anywhere. They can take this fight out into the streets if they want to. You know, some say Violet Evans belongs to the streets. I don't know if I agree with them. Into a tequila sunrise. Evans trying to make this a short matchup, looking to embarrass Jane Stone here tonight, but that ain't gonna happen. A couple of boots gonna get her out of that tequila sunrise. Butterfly suplex. Stone to come in our main event, guys, up next. A fatal four-way tornado tag team matchup. Look at this, Jane Stone looking to introduce some weapons. Violet Evans trying to stop her and does before she can pull something out. The fans, they still want tables. They got a table earlier tonight, but it's not enough, man. They're pining for a table. Nice counter by Jane Stone. Like I said, this ain't gonna be a wrestling match like when these two last faced off one-on-one. They're not coming out here tonight to prove who the better wrestler is. Now Violet Evans looking for a weapon. And gonna bring out the table! Is she gonna pull a knee on though? No, actually uses it, smashing Jane Stone in the face. It's a hard wood, and now gut first into the steel steps. Rushes into the pin. Violet Evans thinks she has it won here. One. Two! Only a two count though. And right back into the tequila sunrise, same position as well. Violet Evans evidently wants to get the submission win here tonight. Force Jane Stone to tap out, but I don't think Stone's doing that anytime soon. Not gonna give Evans the satisfaction. Look at Violet Evans rocking the jean shorts here though. When's the last time you saw someone wear jean shorts? Snap vertical suplex into a cover. Great camera angle. Get in the back of that fan's head. Jane Stone thrown down onto the table. See, there's a big crack in it. She's got the table once again. Going to bring it into the ring. Violet Evans looking to set the table up, perhaps, but sees that Jane Stone is getting back up to her feet. Evans has been largely in control so far. Jane Stone trying to change that. The X-Plex! Rough landing. Get in the ring. Jane Stone grabs a kendo stick. What else? Oh, right down across the shoulder, man. We've got that kendo stick budget here in CMB. Swinging a neck breaker by Stone. And chest first into the ring apron. Jane Stone looking for that Yokosuka cutter, perhaps. And there it is. Violet Evans smacking face first. Down onto the mat. Very little protection for the concrete floor that lies beneath. Only gets a two count, though, for Jane Stone. And you know what she's going to be looking for? Jane Stone looking for that rolling knee bar of hers, but Violet Evans counters with the knee to the jaw. Oh, Dragon Sleeper! Dragon Sleeper locked in by Violet Evans. She's got it in tight as well. Dragon Sleeper, but counters at it into Stone and a kick to the back. What a reversal. Violet Evans looking for an X-Plex of her own. Counters into a small package. One, two. Jane Stone nearly stealing it there. Back into the ring goes Jane Stone. She wants to get her hands on that table. Violet Evans coming to join her. Immediately gets smacked in the face. Now puts it in the corner. Jane Stone, what is she cooking up here? What is she thinking about? Nothing pretty. Going after the arm. Trying to rip it right off, I'm sure. Jane Stone. Perhaps looking to drag Violet Evans over to the table, but Evans able to keep her at bay. Back down to the outside we go. To the side of the head, Johnson making sure to stay on top of these two. You never know when a pinfall can happen. Kendo stick in hand right to the top of the head, and again, it goes face first to the barricade too, but a kick to the head gonna knock the kendo stick down out of the ground. Oh, not one of these knees from Violet Evans. She's the one. Want to bring it home and put it in her trophy case. The arm of my former tag team partner. Into the ring we go. Jane Stone moving a little bit slower here, but moving she is. Violet Evans catches her. Butterfly suplex countered by Stone. She fucking lands it. That was cheap. Drops Stone. Drops Evans, I should say, on her head with that half Nelson suplex. Checking to make sure the table is secure. Stone really wants to put Evans through that table, but Evans making it a very hard task in the Tree of Woe. Letting the blood rush to Stone's head as she delivers that spine cracking backstabber. Weary here. I'm gonna let Stone catch her off guard like she nearly did earlier with that small package. Steel chair. Age old equalizer right to the head of Jane Stone. Just gets right back up and hits the bicycle super kick. Vintage Stone. One, two. How many people do you know can take a steel chair to the head and come right back at you? Now Stone with the chair, but Evans able to roll out of the way, and Violet Evans looking to hit the X-Plex! Surely that'll do it. One, two, no! Violet Evans not able to believe it. Release. Tiger Bomb! Stone smacked the back of her head off the mat. Violet Evans, guys, might be looking to set Jane Stone up for that Dragon Sleeper. We saw her use this over the last couple of weeks. The Romero Dragon Sleeper is locked in. Stone's body bending back in a sickening way. Surely she'll tap here. She doesn't tap. She refuses to tap, but the damage might be done. One, two, three, Violet Evans. Once again victorious against Jane Stone. We knew these two were gonna beat the hell out of each other, and that's exactly what we got. An absolute war in this street fight. And Jane Stone, man, valiant until the end, did not tap. But the damage just too much to keep fighting. But what a win for Violet Evans. More momentum going into the Magnificent Eight ladder match at Ascendance 10. Will that be our Miss Magnificent Eight? Here we go, my fine feather friends. It is time for our main event of the evening. Fatal 4-Way Tornado Tag Team Action as the four participants of the Global Championship matchup at Ascendance 10. Defending champion Cam Harris, Jason Spade, Blake Virtue, and Troy Colt have been tasked with finding themselves some tag team partners here tonight. That all-important momentum up for grabs. With Ascendance 10 less than a week away. This Friday and Saturday, August the 5th and 6th. Do not miss it. Cam Harris defending his global championship against Jason Spade, Blake Virtue, and Troy Colt in a Fatal 4-Way First to Two Falls match. That and so much more. It's the biggest show in CMB history. You're going to be a fool if you're not there. Sin City Savior has not had exactly the best reign since capturing the global championship at Purgatory. But he certainly did show just how ruthless he can be. Last episode of Octane, guys, when he absolutely brutalized Ethan Parker after an interesting interference by Blake Virtue, put his theme song on the PA system and just played it during the entire match. That seemed to just whip Cam Harris into a frenzy as he just, gosh, I've never seen Cam Harris so aggressive before. Destroyed Ethan Parker. Ended up making him tap out for that modified crossface. And if Cam Harris brings that same level of intensity to Ascendance 10, I believe he'll leave still CMB Global Champion. And Cam Harris choosing Richie James Harden to be his tag team partner here tonight. These two have teamed up in the past. Richie James Harden said to be a part of the Money in the Bank ladder match at Ascendance 10. Will the Money in the Bank briefcase be super clean? Teaming with Violet Evans last episode of Octane against James Stone and Bloody Justice. The match ended up getting thrown out by disqualification because Richie James Harden forgot the rules and just stood in the ring while referee Johnson counted him out. Lucky for Richie James Harden, there are no countouts or disqualifications here in this match, nor will there be at Ascendance 10 in the Money in the Bank ladder match. Jason Spade certainly finding himself quite a tag team partner. Only a little over a month ago, Jay Young and Jason Spade were at each other's throats, but following the ultimate submission match at Absolution, both men finding respect for each other, and Jay Young willing to help out Jason Spade here tonight. Pick up some momentum for himself going into the Money in the Bank ladder match, of course failing to recapture his international championship last episode of Octane in the triple threat, which was won by Amber Reed, of course. Jay Young, personal pick of a lot of members of the CMB universe I know, and honestly, if I could be a bit biased for a second, Jay Young, my pick to climb that ladder and unhook that briefcase. And Jay Young has proven, especially here in the new season, that he is main event caliber. Feels as though it's about time for him to take that next step. Will it happen at Ascendance 10? And of course, the sneaky little weasel, some have come to call him, after it was originally announced we'd see a triple threat match in Ascendance 10 between Blake Virtue, Troy Colt, and Cam Harris for the CMB Global Championship, but Jason Spade leaning on his relationship with Octane General Manager Madison Wright to get himself added to the match, making it a fatal four-way. And the CMB Universe not happy. Certainly, Virtue, Colt, and Harris not happy. Jason Spade's been getting a lot of flack as of late, but Spade doesn't give a shit because he got what he wants. Another shot at the CMB Global Championship. Bloody Justice, of course, another participant in the Money in the Bank ladder match at Ascendance 10. A very interesting pick for Blake Virtue to be his tag team partner here tonight. Of course, Virtue doesn't have a whole lot of friends left these days, considering he's two of his longtime friends in the Fatal 4-Way at Ascendance 10. Not really his friends anymore, though. Blake Virtue has got a knack for getting under people's skin. Cam Harris. Colt Val will be facing both, and Justice wins in the end. And the best bout machine, Blake Virtue, showing up at Ascendance 10 to try and become a three-time CMB Global Champion. Lost his title to Troy Colt back at Absolution in what many considered a shock. Then, of course, Troy Colt lost the title to Cam Harris at Purgatory, which many considered a shock. But there will be no shock at Ascendance 10, says Blake Virtue. He will leave a three-time CMB Global Champion. Make up for what happened at Ascendance 9, where he was the first one eliminated in that Fatal 5-Way. Virtue says there's no chance in hell him leaving Ascendance 10 without that global championship around his waist. I'm sure that Blake Virtue can't be very happy to see this man partaking in our main event here tonight. Honestly, I'm shocked that Ethan Parker was even cleared to compete after what Cam Harris did to him last episode of Octane. But Parker has proven in an incredibly short amount of time just how tenacious he is. What a few weeks he's had, man. At the top of the month, had a war with Jason Spade, a phenomenal matchup, came up short, but then the week after, defeated Blake Virtue, pinned the two-time global champion, clean 1-2-3 after an awesome matchup. And then, of course, last episode of Octane, we might have had another big victory for Ethan Parker, if not for Blake Virtue interfering and Cam Harris going berserk. Again, I'm shocked to even see this kid walking out here tonight, but that just proves his toughness. Troy Colt obviously taking notice of the rookie, choosing him as his tag team partner here tonight. Ethan Parker set to be a part of the Slick B Memorial Battle Royal. Honestly, might be my pick. Last but far from least, the former CMB Global Champion, Troy Colt, made it to the top of the mountain, man, in a relative short amount of time. And his CMB career debuted towards the end of last season and at Absolution beat Blake Virtue to become the CMB Global Champion, but just a month later at Purgatory was upset by his longtime friend, the Sin City Savior, Cam Harris. Troy Colt says there won't be another upset in Ascendance 10. He's coming to that fatal four-way, coming to the grandest stage of them all to become a global champion once more. Not going to let anyone stand in his way. Here we go, fatal four-way tornado tag team action. No countouts, no disqualifications. Obviously, all eight men act at the same time. It's not elimination style, though. That means the first team to gain pinfall or submission in the ring gets that victory, gets that big push of momentum going into Ascendance 10 this weekend. Nasty Fisherman's Driver from Blake Virtue to Jay Young is bloody justice. Harden squaring up. Parker going to throw him out onto the apron. Big right hook trying to knock him down to the outside. There we go. Drops him first on the top rope. Troy Colt hits Cam Harris. That leg drop bulldog of his. Later on tonight, guys, of course, will be Ignition episode 16. And after that, the next time you see us go live will be for Ascendance 10. This Friday and Saturday, August 5th and 6th, right here at twitch.tv/DJUri. You do not want to miss it. The biggest show in CMB history, live from Paddy France. What a card we have in store. As Richie James Harden smashed by Ethan Parker at ringside. Jason's made sense of money. Cam Harris sneaking up on Spade. Spade has never exactly been well liked by the majority of the CMB universe or that locker room in the past, but I have never seen him so universally hated as he is right now after weaseling his way into the global championship match at Ascendance 10. There's not a single person in that locker room or in this audience, except for Madison Wright, that can stand Jason Spade. Oh, Troy Colt just heated out of the ring by Bloody Justice. But it's only Cam Harris and Jason Spade are left in the ring now. Parker is just beating the hell out of Richie James Harden this entire match. Someone bleeding as well. I'm not too sure who, but someone has been busted open. I think it's Ethan Parker is bleeding. Richie James Harden must have gotten a nice shot in. Side of BJ's head, courtesy of Troy Colt. Jay Young and Blake Virtue continue to beat the hell out of each other here in front of the announce table. Parker thinking for a second about giving Richie James Harden a break, but where's the fun in that? As he instead drops him face first on the barricade. And Harris and the ring guys just give a J Jason Spade working the global champion up to the top rope. Boba at ringside, sit out powerbomb from Cold to Bloody Justice in the ring. Cam Harris with a DDT attempt, but Spade able to sidestep him. Down onto his knees and hit with a knee. Oh, in the ring! In the ring! Collar City Clutch! Collar City Clutch by Spade! Locked in on Cam Harris! The global champion in big trouble here as Spade looks to gain some big time momentum going into the fatal four-way. Right side, might have missed Troy Colt, powerbombing Bloody Justice out of the freaking apron. This truly is a fluster cut. Cam Harris now put him against the ropes. Richie James Harden coming to the rescue of his tag team partner. Spade gonna deal with him. That head scissors whip, and right back onto the attack. Limps into the fatal four-way at Ascension's head. Super kick, but blocked by Cam Harris. Bloody Justice taking his fight with Troy Colt into the ring. Spade having his way with the Sin City Savior in this match. A barrage of knees to the midsection, and now washing the face of Cam Harris. Big boom! Has got Cam Harris hurt, looking to take him out. Lands him for the bottomy. Spade hooks the leg. Will that be enough to get the dub? 1, 2, 3, it will. Jay Young and Jason Spade victorious. Ethan Parker could have saved there, but chose not to. Perhaps some low-key revenge on Cam Harris for what transpired last episode, allowing him to get pinned here. Because look at this. Spade hooked the leg. And you can see Ethan Parker, look at this. He could have so easily broken up that pin, but he just got out of the ring again. Ethan Parker getting his revenge against Cam Harris as Jay Young and Jason Spade victorious tonight. Big time momentum for both men, sharing a high five, something I didn't think I'd see. Will that be Mr. Money in the Bank? Will that be the new global champion? We find all of that out and more at Ascendance 10.